Hello, I'm Gloria Mata Pennington, and it's my privilege to serve as president of the Austin Friends of Folk Art. The Austin Friends of Folk Art were created in 1987 when a small group of very enthusiastic folk art lovers got together and created the group. They wanted to learn more about folk art, but not only that, they wanted to promote folk art. They wanted to preserve folk art because they thought that folk art was so important to the cultures of the world. They've been doing that since 1987, and our members have wonderful, wonderful collections. And today, you're in for a real treat. We have as our guest, Ed Jordan, and we're going to be featuring his marvelous collection, and you're going to be astonished that someone in Austin, Texas has such a passion for Mexican folk art that he has collected for many years and that he's willing to share it with us.
I'm a native Austinite. I was born 1934 here at Breckenridge Hospital, and I'm still here. We moved in this house in 1943, my parents and my two sisters, and eventually I've ended up with it myself. And have filled it up pretty muchly with things I really love and enjoy. In university, I was in art school, and I was spending some time in the art library, which was pretty pathetic back then, but I found a book with an article on Alexandre Girard, a famous designer and illustrator and what have you. And I rushed down the hall to painting class and dragged my friend Lou Ann Barrow out, and I said, come look at what I found. And we both went and really enjoyed it. And both Lou Ann and I have used Alexandre Girard sort of as a mentor, even though he's long gone, for things we love and collect. Girard did the Hemisphere in San Antonio. He did all of Braniff's redo, if y'all remember that, back in, when is that, the 60s, I guess, where he painted the airplanes all wonderful Mexican colors. Anyway, being a native Austinite and native Texan, one invariably goes down on the border, and you come back with a little Tonalá frog or owl or something like that. And so that's really the first pieces of folk art I ever had. Then years later in Dallas, I was working in advertising and buying things that I liked. My advertising years and my art school years and what have you developed a pretty good sense of design and color and all of this. So I'd buy things I liked, the color, the design, or something like that. And I was buying something at a place called Howard Goman Interiors, and his partner, Ruby Hexter, came over and said, Ed, you need to get this. And she handed me a piece of Mexican folk art, which is gorgeous, from Metapec, and I found out later. And she said, stop collecting all this junk. Go after the Mexican folk art. And so I thought, she's a smart lady. I'll do that. So all of a sudden, I've just got lots of Mexican folk art. I started collecting from all over the world folk art because it was charming, delightful, and I loved it. Then I decided, well, I don't have the income to do that. And then I thought, well, I'll concentrate on Mexico. Well, that quickly proved to me I didn't have the income for that either. So I then concentrated on certain things. And one of my favorite people, artists in Mexico, is Jeron Martinez Mendoza from Acatlan de Osorios in Puebla State. And I think just by no work on my part, I've ended up with over 70 pieces of his, which really surprises me. But the other things I collect are trees of life. I mean, who can resist a tree of life? And I hate to think how many I have. I don't want to talk in numbers, but these things just happen to me. I walk in someplace and there's something there that I've got to have because I know what it is. And that's the advantage of being a folk art collector, in that I know what I'm looking for and I know what something is when I see it. And the person who donated it to Goodwill or the thrift shop or whatever has no idea. It's just a piece of junk to them. I love having people in my house, and like you all, and these things are so wonderful, so precious, and they're all one of a kind. They aren't mass produced. You can't go to Foley's or whoever is doing that, Macy's, I guess, and find 1,500 of them there. Everything I have is one of a kind. There is no duplicate. Getting ready to sell this property. It's time to move on and do something. So I'm going to have to, take things apart and send them various places and what have you. And what you will see in this film will never be duplicated. The way I put things together, the way I've arranged things, that's not going to happen ever again. So this is a one time only chance to see things as I have them, as I want them. It's amazing, no matter what the anthropologists or archaeologists say, similar things are done all over the world. I've got a piece of Heron that is a stack of animals. Well, have you been to Bremen, Germany, and seen the Stadt musicians of Bremen? It's the same thing. And Isaacar de Matamoros, the florist and family, does the same type of thing. So these ideas go all around the world. I don't know how they get various places, but I've got pots that look like they could be from, Russia. I've got pots that could have been done in France somewhere. At the Travis County History Day, collecting is like a influenza. It's a disease and it's catching and you can't stop it. So I don't know. I'm going to be getting rid of some things because of moving out of this house, but I don't think that's going to have anything to do with my collecting ability. Friends of Folk Art has been a tremendous, and the Mexican Art Museum downtown have been tremendous assets in my life. At the moment, Mexicarte has several of my nativities from Mexico, a Teodoro Blanco nativity, a Sinsansun nativity, and I took some little glass pieces down there I hope they'll use. But it's wonderful to have a place to show these, and it's wonderful to be around a group of people who know what I'm talking about.